I'm writing a theoretical paper why there are lots of things out there that we probably should be calling vitamins that are more long-term things. I'll give you just one example. The two carotenoids are these orange pigments in every plant. The reason they turn orange in the fall in New England is because the chlorophyll goes away and you're left with this orange carotenoid. Beta carotene is a good example. Now that also goes to vitamin A, but that's a different thing. So there's 600 carotenoids in nature, but humans have about 15 or 20 of them in the brain. And in the macular of the eye, there's a yellow spot that has two carotenoids in them, lutein and zeaxanthin, which nobody called vitamins, but nature's putting them in the macular of your eye. And if you don't get them, you get macular degeneration. The eye people have shown that. What do carotenoids do? Well, the reason they're orange is they have all these conjugated double bonds. And if you have light and a dye, the energy of that light gets transmitted to oxygen, and you can make something called singlet oxygen, which is a very energetic form of oxygen that can oxidize things much better than just plain oxygen. So that's nasty in a cell because it starts destroying all your structure. And what plants use, and they're out in the light all the time in strong light, what they do is they have these carotenoids which dissipate that extra energy of singlet oxygen as heat in this double bond chain and detoxify it. And people have worked all that out. So, and in the macula of the eye, that yellow color absorbs blue light, which is the most toxic form of light. So it keeps your eyes from oxidizing in the key part of your eye. Well, so people sort of understand that. Shouldn't that be a vitamin? It's just a longevity vitamin. It's something that's helping your long-term health. And I think it should be. Anyway, I'm writing a paper arguing all of that.